Right. So once the OAuth is complete, we are all set to go ahead and extract some tweets. This process or this step is the data collection phase. Okay. So we can just harvest some tweets and we can see what people are talking about any topic. Okay. Right now I'm taking the search string as Tanushree Datta. Right now that's a very hot and happening topic in Bollywood circle. So let's see what people are talking about. Okay. So a very simple command. I'm just by now you know how to create an object, right? I've created the object name TD tweets. TD tweets is Tanushree Datta tweets. Okay. Equals search Twitter. Double quotes mein ye Tanushree Datta le liya. Okay. Agar if you are doing any search for a hashtag, yahan par hashtag that, like hashtag me too. If let us say a lot of me too campaign is running, so me too ko pe search karna hai, so I'll put hashtag me too. Okay. Right now I'm taking Tanushree Datta and n equals to 100. N means the number of tweets that you want. Okay. You can see per day, I think you can extract around 18,000 tweets per day. Okay. Twitter can allow you to extract 18,000 tweets per day, but it's not the point of Twitter. It's the capability of your machine also. Right now, if I write anything more than 100 or 1,000, my machine will hang. I know that. So I'm not doing that. So I'm just taking a small number, N equals to 100. Just this is just for a demo purpose. For that reason, I'm just going ahead with N equals to 100. Okay. And language, you specify it as English. Even if you don't want, you can remove it. This is optional. Okay. Not a necessary requirement. Okay. And once I run this, I'm just keeping the command minimalistic. Okay. I'm not putting much arguments into it. You can also specify since and okay, till, like timeline also. Okay. We'll go ahead with that. We'll come back. Just right now, we are extracting some basic tweets and learning how to extract them. Okay. So you can see even for 100, the system takes some time to extract. Okay. So I did not get any error. That means the tweets have been extracted. So I just see what is there in this object TD tweets. Okay. And if I run this, these are the tweets which I have just extracted about Tanushree Datta. Okay. The latest 100 tweets have been extracted. Fine. It takes the latest. It's like, you know, last in, first out. Okay. So most often this takes the LIFO principle only. Okay. You can even specify, I think, search type equals to recent. You can put that argument equals to. Yeah. Okay. So a lot of arguments can be added. Type equals to recent. You can specify the timeline since and okay. Since ke baad kya hota hai? What is the combination with since? Tabrez sir. Since ke sab kya hota hai? Since. Since and. Since is the beginning date. And since two. Since. From two. Okay. Nahin, object, I'm giving a name. Okay, this TD tweets is the name of the object which I have created. You don't like TD tweets, you can put anything. Okay. Fine. So we have extracted some tweets. So data is collected. Fine. Quite simple. Now, just to check, you know, always whenever we are extracting this data from Twitter, we are extracting some tweets. This gets extracted in the form of a list. Okay. You can see the class, it is in the form of a list. And list is not that user friendly to manipulate. So it is advisable that we convert this into a data frame, which we are very comfortable with, right? So the next step is we will convert the data or convert the tweets, which is extracted into a data frame. Okay. So very simple. The object is TD tweets, for which now I'll use TW list to DF. TW, this is from the Twitter package. Okay. These commands are from the Twitter package. So for that, TW is Twitter only. Okay. Then list to data frame. This is the other new. Nahin, mera screen chota hai. So mere ko niche ka nahi dikhega. Okay. Okay, you can see I'm using the maximum space for the script area only. So, okay. So now let us see. Right, sir, you can come forward. Okay, so I'm converting this into data frame. So it is now saved in the form of a data frame. And if you want to view that, view TD. Okay, now this will look. Now you can see the entire thing has got converted into a neat data frame. Okay, you have the tweets, favorited, favorite count, reply, created on, okay, truncated. All this is Twitter terminology, not to worry. You get all the details. Okay. So the entire data that you have extracted now has been converted into a clean data frame. Okay. Chalo. Sorry. Now you can check the class. Obviously, this should be a data frame. This was the purpose. Originally, it was a list. Now we transformed into a data frame. Right. Now you can write the same thing into a CSV file also. Okay. You can save the entire data in the form of a CSV file. Let us say you are doing a project or it's a capstone project. You will definitely need to collect the data and save it in a CSV file. Okay. So you can write the same thing into a CSV file. Write.csv, the same command. Okay. Write.csv, whatever the object name is and whatever name you desire. Yeah. Okay. So something went wrong somewhere. Okay. So anyway, so this is the entire process where we started off with data collection and then we converted the same data from list to data frame and then we saved it in the form of a CSV file.
Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.